गुड मॉर्निंग, आई डॉक्टर भरत मकवाना, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री फ्रॉम एचवीएच इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट स्टडीज एंड रिसर्च. इट इज अ कंस्टिट्यूशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ कड़ी सर्व विश्वविद्यालय. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द केमिस्ट्री ऑफ कोफायरिंग. सो कोफायरिंग आर वन ऑफ द वाइटल केमिकल यूनिट एसेंशियल फॉर द सर्वाइवल लाइफ प्रोसेस ऑन द अर्थ. वी नो दैट द कोफायरिंग इट इज अ वन काइंड ऑफ नेचुरल पिगमेंट्स बिलोंग टू द पायरल group contain a complex stable structure composed of four pyrrole nucleus. So basically it is a pigment, and we see on the nature there are lot of pigments is available and very popular are hemoglobin and chlorophyll. So many biological molecules function with the prosthetic group essentially made of this unit. It is nothing but the porphyrin. For example, a chlorophyll of chloroplast which derive photosynthesis, hemin as a component of hemoglobin that transport to oxygen to animal tissue, and as a central unit of myoglobin ensure the storage of oxygen. All of these have active site essentially made of the porphyrin core, and that's why we are going to discuss the chemistry of porphyrin structure or chemistry of porphyrin. So basically biologically it is very very important molecules for the life cycle. It is a very necessary component. So porphyrin it's serve as a prosthetic group for the protein that function in oxygen transportation, like hemoglobin and myoglobin both are the helpful for the oxygen transporter. Breakdown of the peroxide like catalyze electron transfer via cytochromes, and hydroxylation like cytochrome P450. Nitric oxide synthesis and light absorption. Definitely light absorption or photosynthesis is very very important for the life cycle. So chlorophyll, it's a porphyrin which helpful to this reaction. So porphyrin are a heterocyclic ring structure that include a four pyrrole ring joined together through a carbon with a methanyl bridge. The most important porphyrin in nature are found in a hemoglobin and the chlorophyll. Hemoglobin is necessary for the human life and chlorophyll for the entire plants. In the central, the porphyrin, a matter atom is chelated to the nitrogen atom on the pyrrole unit. So porphyrin structure have four pyrrole unit and there four nitrogen interact or the coordinate with the central metal ion. In case of hemin, they related the porphyrin atom bind with the iron, and in case of the chlorophyll, the central metal ion is magnesium. So porphyrin a cyclic compound then bind with the metal ion. In case of chlorophyll, it's a magnesium, and it is necessary for the central to solar energy utilization. Hemin, it have a Fe+2 ion which most prevalent metal of porphyrin and humans, and central to oxygen sensing and utilization. Dear friends, if you talk about the cyanocobalamin, so cobalamin have a cobalt metal ion, and bacterial coenzyme which have a nickel sector metal ion. So now see, this is the structure of the porphyrin. It is nothing but the cyclic structure with four pyrrole ring A, B, C, and D linked with the methanyl bridge. So it will bind with the methanyl bridge. If you talk about the chlorophyll and hemoglobin, it will bind with, here as a central metal ion. So this is the structure of porphyrin with molecular formula is C20H14 and N4. Now see, this is some things belong from the porphyrin. So porphyrin have a side chain substituted by the methyl functional group. We talk about the vinyl functional group, propionyl functional group, and acetyl functional group. So this is the basic structure of the porphyrin structure, which might be possible if four pyrrole ring A, B, C, D, their substitution like vinyl functional group or methyl functional group at alpha and beta position. This is called a methanyl group or the methanyl ring, and here P can represent the propionyl group. So basically it is a four pyrrole ring held by the methylene bridge, and metal ion bind with the nitrogen atom with as a complex metal of porphyrin. There are eight hydrogen atom substituted at four different pyrrole and four pyrrole close as a bracket of unsubstitution, nothing but the bridge. So there are, according to the cyclic structure, there are two type of porphyrin. Type 1 porphyrin, it is a symmetrical arrangement of substitution group on all eight position, like position 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 with all 8 position are substituted by symmetrical function group. We can say it's a euro porphyrin 1, and simultaneously porphyrin type 3 porphyrin, it is asymmetrical arrangement of substitution group on all 8 positions. For this 8 function, 8 position can be functionalized by different functional group. We can say it is euro porphyrin 3. So according to their arrangement of substitution at pyrrole position, we make a two type of porphyrin structure. Now this is the two fabulous structure belong from the porphyrin chemistry. This is the structure of amine and this is the structure of chlorophyll. Both are very very necessary for the life cycle. See that there are a lot of similarity. Both are the porphyrin structure, both have a 4-pyrrole, both have a methylene bridge, but see something is different. The central metal ion is different. In case of hemin, it is iron. In case of chlorophyll, there is a magnesium, and their alpha and beta position might be different. Majorly the alpha position have a methyl functional group, but beta position of 4-pyrrole 1, 2 and 3. See, pyrrole 1 and 2 have a 2 vinyl functional group, and pyrrole 3 and 4, their beta position is propionic acid chain. Simultaneously in pyrrole A 1 and 2, there is a vinyl functional group and ethyl functional group, but in pyrrole number 3 and 4, there is a long chain like a phytol. So this is the difference between the structure of amine and chlorophyll. Definitely when we discuss the chemistry or the constitution of amine and chlorophyll, we'll discuss on detail. So chlorophyll, this is the full structure of the chlorophyll, which have a long chain of phytol, fine. And there is a chlorophyll A and B, then the substitution is different. In case of chlorophyll, there is a methyl functional group. But if we talk about the chlorophyll B, there is an aldehyde functional group. And we know that it is very helpful to photosynthesis reaction, fine. So in any plant which have a green color pigment, it is connected to the chlorophyll, and it will helpful to a photosynthesis reaction. Now, all porphyrin are nothing but the combination of porphyrinobilinogen, PBG, basic molecules. So this is the structure of porphyrinobilinogen. Now, these four porphyrinobilinogen, PBG, condensed together and ring closer and making isomerization, different europorphyrinogens are possible. If we substitute at alpha and beta position, we are getting to a different europorphyrinogen 3. Now see, this is the example of europorphyrinogens. Their substituted functional group are different to each other. This is the structure of protoporphyrin. If we see the structure of porphyrin, there is a 4-pyrrole ring with closure with the methylene linkage, and see that different substitution. Their alpha position at methyl, here is methyl and methyl. But the beta position of pyrrole 1 and 2, there is a vinyl functional group here and here. And pyrrole 3 and 4, there is a propionic acid. If you mix with the iron, it will convert to a hemoglobin. So at central metal ion, if it is iron is present, it will interact with this 4-nitrogen, and we are getting to hemoglobin structure. So now this is the synthesis of the porphyrin. It was synthesized by the Calvin in 1943. It's quite easy. Take the 4 mole of the pyrrole in presence of the formaldehyde and methanol in presence of pyridine solvent. We are getting to a tetracyclic structure. This is a condensation of 4-pyrrole with the formaldehyde. So this is a formal structure of the porphyrin. Now this porphyrin can be substituted at the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, 8 position. So we are getting to a different substituted porphyrin. So here we discuss about the first substituted porphyrin, so that is the etioporphyrin. So see, this is the dipyrrole methanes. We can make the etioporphyrin with the help of the dipyrrole methanes. In presence of succinic acid, we are getting to a cyclic structure, and this cyclic structure, it is nothing but the etioporphyrin. So this synthesis was invented by the H. Fischer on 1926. This is again the condensation reaction, and now see that this is a symmetrical porphyrin because their alpha position have methyl and methyl. But if we talk about the beta position, this is ethyl functional group. Here is ethyl functional group. This is the ethyl functional group. this is the ethylene sulfur. So we can say it is a very simple substituted porphyrin structure, ethyl porphyrin. Simultaneously, you can synthesize the some another substituted porphyrin structure like mesoporphyrin. So again, in case of mesoporphyrin, we are taking to dipyrimethanes. Here we have a dipyrimethane. We mix together, we are getting to a cyclic structure of porphyrin. But see the difference between the ethyl-porphyrin and mesoporphyrin. The substituted functional group are different. The first pyrrole have a methyl and ethyl. Second pyrrole have methyl and ethyl. But see the third and fourth, there is a methyl functional group. And here methyl functional group here. This is a propionic acid side chain. This is the also a propionic acid side chain. So we can say that it is just structure like a meso. If we make a plane of symmetry at here, it is a meso structure. So that's why we can say it is a mesoporphyrin structure. Now we discuss the isomerization of porphyrin. So as we already know that any porphyrin structure, it was substituted by different functional group, we are getting to a derivative of porphyrin. So the substitutions such like the methyl functional group, vinyl functional group, or many more functional group at the alpha or beta position, we are getting to a different porphyrin structure. So very basic porphyrin like ethyl-porphyrin. So according to a structure of ethyl-porphyrin, which we already discussed on synthesis, there is a methyl and ethyl functional group and all the four structure. So if you see the methyl and ethyl on alpha and beta position of porphyrin structure, according to arrangement of the four, according to arrangement of the methyl and ethyl functional group at porphyrin 1, 2, and 3 and 4. So all these are nothing but the isomer structure of ethyl porphyrin. It is the nothing but the arrangement of that methyl and ethyl functional group. Fine. Now, after the discussion of the porphyrin, we are moving to our first structure. This is the hemin structure. So, before we move into a constitution of hemoglobin, we are discussing about something is basic thing of the hemin. So, hemin, it is a one ferrous atom in the center of the tetrapyrrole ring, which is called protoporphyrin. So, protoporphyrin structure attested with the iron as center metal, and we are going to a hemoglobin. So, the prosthetic group for hemoglobin is hemoglobin and myoglobin, the cytochrome catalase and tryptophan pyrrolase, nitric oxide synthesis, and many more. So function of the hemin will be helpful to oxygen sensing with hemin and hemoproteins, oxygen transport by the hemomyoglobin, oxygen storage by the myoglobin, and electron transport via the cytochrome, oxidation via cytochrome P45 and tryptophan pyrrolase, decomposition and activation of hydrogen peroxide via catalyze and peroxide, nitric oxide synthesis, regulation of cellular process, and effector of apoptosis. So these are the function of the hemoglobin. Now see, this is the structure of hemoglobin. It is the derivative of the porphyrin. It is a four pyrrole ring, 1, 2, 3, 4. It was substituted by the alpha position like methyl. Here is methyl, here is methyl, and here is methyl. And beta position, we are getting to a vinyl functional group, propionic acid chain and propionic acid, and central metal ion via iron. So we need to prove the constitution of hemoglobin. This is the structure of hemoglobin. Now we step by step prove the position of vinyl group or presence of vinyl group, presence of propionic acid chain, the substitution of pyrrole and central metal ion. So it is a simplified representation of hemin. You see, this is the structure of hemin. You can remember easily, M can be represented the methyl functional group. So there is a four methyl functional group at alpha position. V is represent the vinyl functional group. It will represent at the beta position of pyrrole 1 and 2. And P is representation of propionic acid side chain, which is present at the pyrrole number 3 and 4. So from this representation, we can easily understand and remember the structure of hemin. Now see, this is some fundamental thing of hemoglobin. Hemoglobin, it is the red blood pigments. You can see it's a chromoprotein exceptionally fine in human or erythrocytes. The protein parts on hemoglobin is 94% and prosthetic group is around 6% only. So normal range of concentration of hemoglobin in blood is, on case of male, it is 14 to 16 milligram. In case of female, there is 13 to 15 milligram. And it is a tetrameric allostatic proteins. Their molecular weight around 64,415. It is a conjugated protein because of hemin and globin. Example of the quaternary structure of protein. It's a globular protein, consists of four pyropeptide chains, two of one type and two of another types. It's called iron protoporphyrin complex, and other iron protoporphyrin complex are peroxide, cytochrome, and catalase. Now see, this is the transportation of oxygen and carbon dioxide by hemoglobin. So carbon dioxide binds to hemoglobin, it will convert to carboaminohemoglobin. Now this carboaminohemoglobin act at the lungs, and CO2 is released from hemoglobin. Oxygen will bind to hemoglobin and it will convert to oxyhemoglobin. So see, this is the cartoon representation of transportation of oxygen by hemoglobin. So CO2 released oxygen from blood, and CO2 carried back to lungs living. Oxygen to be consumed by organ and tissue. And so we take the breath in and breath out by carbon dioxide and oxygen. So delivery of oxygen from the lung to tissue and transport carbon dioxide and proton from tissue to lungs. So this is the transportation of oxygen in hemoglobin. Now, as we know that hemoglobin, it is a hemoprotein. It is porphyrin ring plus iron. You can see it's a hemi plus proteins. This is the 3D structure of hemoglobin, and we need to prove the constitution of hemoglobin structure. Now see, there is a two chain like alpha chain and beta chain. This is the polypeptide chain, beta chain, and this is the alpha chain. It make a hemoglobin, it bind with the iron. This is the structure of the hemoglobin. Now iron containing compound belong to the class of protoporphyrin compounds. So protoporphyrin is composed with the four pyrrole rings. So pyrrole, four pyrrole condenses together, it will get into a protoporphyrin. Here this is a methylene bridge. M, it is representing the four methyl functional group. V, it is a two vinyl functional group. And P is representing the two propionate side chains group. And this is made nothing but the protoporphyrin structure. It is a tetrapyrrole ring. Now iron Fe plus 2 held in the center of the protoporphyrin molecules. By the coordination, we are getting to a hemin structure, which four nitrogen it coordinate with the center metal ion iron. We are getting to a hemoglobin structure. So protoporphyrin will convert to a hemin structure. Now see, this is the hemin structure. We need to prove it. There is a four pyrrole. All the four pyrrole are substituted. There is propionate side chain. There is a two vinyl functional group and methylene bridge and center metal ion. So as we already know that the hemoglobin as conjugated protein consists of the globin and hemin. Now it is well known that the ferrous normally has six covalent number. So but in structure of the hemin, there is a four nitrogen. It is easily coordinate or bind with the iron. Now with the pyridine, with the pyridine, it will give to a pyridine hemoglobin. So according to iron, you have six covalent number, two pyridine can be bind to the structure of hemoglobin. So from this experiment, we can say that similarly, hemoglobin also coordinate with the imidazole ring of the histidine, that main amino acid of the globin. So there is a four nitrogen and there is two globin. Fine, out of the two globin, there is histidine amino acid bind to the iron, and it will carry to oxygen. We are getting to oxyhemoglobin. So there are this is the mechanism of the oxyhemoglobin. Now, since the constitution of the hemoglobin molecular formula is C34H32 N4O4 and FeCl. So now we seen the structure of the hemoglobin. Now we proved it. When we treat the methanol and hydrochloric acid, HME gives to a dye ester. It indicate that it should be a present of two HCl group, because when we treat with the methanol and hydrochloric acid, the carboxylic functional group will convert to a ester. So it indicate that that should be presence of two carboxylic group. So we already know that there is a propionic acid side chain which is the confirmation by this test. Now another test, one catalytic reduction with the help of palladium hydrogenation. Hamming absorbs the 2 mole of the hydrogen. So this 2 mole of hydrogen absorbed by nothing but the 2 vinyl functional group present on the pyrrole number 1 and pyrrole number 2. So this 2 vinyl functional group absorbs the 2 mole of the hydrogen, which indicate that there should be a presence of 2 double bond. And after the reduction, we are getting to tetrahydro compound. So from this test, we can say that there is a 2 double bond present on the amyl structure, and it is nothing but the 2 vinyl functional group present on the pyrrole number 1 and pyrrole number 2. Third test, we can say the on reduction with the hydrogen iodide and acetic acid. We treat with the hydroiodide and acetic acid, or hydroiodic acid and phosphonium iodide. We treat with this, we are getting to a 4 different substituted pyrrole. Here we are getting to a degraded product of the hamine. 4 substituted pyrrole like oxopyrrole, hemopyrrole, cryptopyrrole and fluoropyrrole. So from 4 substituted pyrrole, we can say that from this degradation reaction, we can say that definitely hemoglobin, it is nothing but the derivative of 4 substituted pyrrole. Now we see the reaction of the each and every pyrrole. Now this is the synthesis of the oxopyrrole. It was synthesized by the NOR. So we are taking the alpha amino acetone, reacts with the ethyl 2,4 diketonate. From the enolization, we are getting the structure, and then finally it converts to a cyclization. Right? From the condensation, we are getting to a cyclization. Right? And this cyclic product going to a reduction of both crystal states in presence of hydrogenide. We are getting this product, and then after, from the sodium ethoxide, we heat at 160 degrees, we are getting to a substituted pyrrole like oxopyrrole. From similarly, we can synthesize other pyrrole derivatives like hemopyrrole, cryptopyrrole, and phyllopyrrole. So enolization, condensation, and then whole crystal reduction with hydrogen added, and finally treat with the sodium ethoxides, we are getting to a 4 different substituted pyrrole derivative. So this conversion, we can say that definitely hemoglobin are nothing but the derivative of 4 pyrrole. Now on other reaction, on reduction with the acen or the tin metal with hydrochloric acid, the 4 pyrrole substituted will give to a substituted carboxylic acid derivative. So here we are getting to oxopyrrole carboxylic acid, hemopyrrole carboxylic acid, cryptopyrrole carboxylic acid and phyllopyrrole carboxylic acid. So their beta position ethyl functional group will convert to a carboxylic acid. So it is also helpful to prove the constitution of hemoglobin. Now one more reaction is that if we have a hemoglobin and having their molecular formula C34, S32 and 4O4 and FeCl. Now this hamine we treat with the chromic acid and sulfuric acid, we are getting to 2 mole of the hematinic acid and methyl malonamide. And other way, we treat with the hamine with the iron dust and formic acid, we are getting to protoporphyrin. So see this protoporphyrin, it is an absence of the iron. If we are going to reduction, we are getting to a mesoporphyrin structure. Fine. So on both the way, with the hamine reduction with the chromic acid and sulfuric acid, we are getting to a methyl malonamide and hamidronic acid. On other hand, we are getting to a protoporphyrin and then mesoporphyrin, and finally on oxidation, we are getting to hamidronic acid. So from this reaction, we can say that the presence of hamidronic acid and methyl malonamide, both the structure are very, very helpful to condensation of the hemoglobin structure, or they are the part of the hemoglobin structure. And now the synthesis of hamidronic acid or methylethyl malonamide, it was ruled by the scientists of Pasteur. So ethyl acetoacetate, sodium ethoxide, and then we are getting to a finally methylethyl malonamide. So the entire reaction, we are getting to methylethyl malonamide. The structure of hamidronic acid was illustrated by the degradation reaction also. So the decarboxylation of hemidinic acid, we are getting to methyl ethyl melanamide. So thus the hemidinic acid may be either a following a three compound. It might be a this, it might be a this, and the third one from the oxidation we are getting to a succinic acid. So out of the three, two would not explain the formation of succinic acid, but the third one it indicate that there is a reaction of the succinic acid. So from these reactions, we can conclude that the hemine consists the substituent of the 4-pyrrole, and from the reaction for or the formation of the hemidinic acid or methyl ethyl melanamide suggests that a pyrrole nucleus are joined with each other by means of the alpha positions, and also suggests that the ring are joined by the means of the carbon atom only. So from the entire reaction we can say that hemoglobin, it is nothing but the derivative of 4-pyrrole or substituted pyrrole. They are joined together by the alpha linkage with the carbon atom. So the four different isomers are possible for the etiopyrrolidine, and all of them have been synthesized, but unfortunately they reassemble very much in their properties. So from the hemine, if it is with the iron and iron dust and formic acid, we are getting the protoporphyrin, which is the absence of iron. If you go into reduction, we are getting to misoporphyrin, and then finally pyrolysis, we are getting to a etioporphyrin structure. So this misoporphyrin on reduction give to a substrate which was recognized as a tetraethyl porphyrin, which is nothing but the etioporphyrin. And four different isomers are possible for the etioporphyrin, which indicate that they are very relevant to structure hemoglobin. Okay? One more thing is that the fact is that ethyl methyl melanamide is formed only after the reduction of hemine, which suggests that there are two unsaturated group reducible like C2H5 are representation on beta position of the hemine molecules, and this group are destroyed during the direct oxidation such as unsaturated group like vinyl. So now we see or conclude here, this is the structure of hemine. If we going to a reduction with we react with the iron and formic acid, we are getting to a protoporphyrin, which is a iron free structure. And if we see, this is a misoporphyrin structure which have a propionic acid. If we going to decarboxylation, we are getting to an etioporphyrin structure. If we going to reduction of this protoporphyrin, the CH2 will convert to CH2 misoporphyrin. So misoporphyrin, etioporphyrin, protoporphyrin, they all are too helpful to prove the constitution of hemoglobin. So finally, we can the structure of hemoglobin prove by the synthesis only by the Fischer on 1929, which like to other porphyrin synthesis consists mainly on two parts. Thank you so much for joining me.